Previously, on Skyrim and Skyrim Special Edition. Meridia's Beacon.
A new hand touches the beacon. Return my beacon to Mount Kilcreath. And I will make you the instrument of my cleansing light.
Statue of Meridia discovered.
The necromancer Malkaran defiles my shrine with vile corruptions. You will enter my temple, retrieve my artifact, and destroy the defiler.
Corrupted Shade. And it seems like it's taking more than one of my sneak attacks, so these things might pack a bit of a punch if it takes more than one bow to take them down. Kilcreath Ruins. Right, even though I'm not crouching, let's get another muffler spell going. Just in case we need to start sneaking in a hurry. It'll be good to have it already in effect. Oh man, this looks like this is going to be a bit more of a puzzle than we originally thought looking at this area. Oh, I see a corrupted shade. I see more than one corrupted shade. Guys, whenever you're ready, you can fire a bow or bite one of them or do something, guys. I've got two companions with me and not one of them did anything then. I mean, I kind of understand Miko not doing anything because he can only bite them and they are ghosts. So I don't know if ghosts can be bitten, but... Janessa, come on, you've been letting me down recently. I speak so highly of you and you let me down. Bingo. Right, let's investigate this floor level first and then we'll make our way up. I get the feeling we're going to have to make our way up the stairs anyway to activate that next beacon. Is there another... Yes, I thought I saw another shade around there. Having all this black mist in the air is actually quite good. It, like, gives them cover to hide behind. Oh, what? I was going to say, but you can't hide from Gaston's arrows, but evidently you can. You can't hide from them, but you can definitely dodge them. Stupid shade. That would have been such a great cinematic shot. I love it when the camera, like, follows the bow. I always think that looks so cool. And then you just might end up looking like an absolute idiot when it misses. Inside these urns. Minor stamina, Oh, a leg of meat. Actually, do you know, well, since I were going through this, I might have to, I just realised something. I thought for a while now, and a lot of you guys have been asking me, and I haven't, other than, like, individual comments, I've never addressed on a, bingo, there we go, on a, like, a wide scale. A lot of you guys have asked if I'm going to be doing mods. Is that something on that plate? An emerald ring! Oh, 700! Yeah, I'll sell that on, that's going to be nice. Yeah, a lot of you guys have asked if I'm going to be doing mods. I thought since I'm just going through here looting and killing corrupted shades, it's not really much going on. I might as well talk about it now. Requires a key. Yeah, I figured that'd be the case. I'm guessing the key is that beacon. But yeah, mods. I'm thinking I'm in an RN about mods. I haven't really looked into many Skyrim mods that I can do, but there are some that I would very much like to do. And if there is, as I said, I haven't looked yet. But if there is one on console, oh, Extreme Magicka. No, I don't really need that. I never use Magicka too much, so Actually, how many magical ones do I do? Because it's always good to have one in handy just in case I need to use my restoration spell, like if I'm really in the pinch. Do I have any for... I don't have any for Magicka. So, yeah, I'm going to take that just in case. Requires key. Yeah, but there's one mod that I would very much like to install, if it exists. I don't know if it even exists yet. But that would be like a survival mode that's like the one that's in Fallout 4. Is that open? That's opened that door, and I'm guessing I have to go through that door to then get to the next beacon. Alright, I think I see what's going on here. But yeah, there's the survival mode in Fallout 4 is where not only do you just have your health, your magicka, all that sort of stuff, but you also need like hunger, thirst, all that sort of stuff as well. So if you don't eat and drink and sleep and stuff like that, then you get more ill. I know there is one for Skyrim for... Let's kill this shade first before I keep talking. I know there is one in Skyrim which is... I can't remember the name of it, but basically if you go in the water or if you go up the mountains for too long, you can die of hypothermia and stuff like that. And I really like the idea of that. I think it adds like an extra challenge to the game, whereas quite often just... You get to a certain point and you're almost untouchable. Like, obviously, I'm nowhere near that point yet, but you play it long enough, eventually you just become so strong, like nothing can touch you. And I feel like that would be a good mod to have. Like, I always try and stay out of the water anyway, because Gaston, he's a Khajiit. He's not a fan of water, but I'm also not a fan of traps, because I see them right there. Let's see if I can spring the trap. Oh, it's a master as well. Let's see if I can spring the trap. Or at least stop the trap from springing and get this door open. If in doubt, what I'm going to do is just get Janessa to open the door for me. I'm sure she could take it. I would ask Miko to, but I don't think he can. Oh man, this is going to take a while. But yeah, I think I'd like a mod for that. So like, as I say, I always stay out of the water anyway. But now is a real reason to, because if I go in the water, I could die of hypothermia. And the only way to get stop myself from happening would be to start a fire or to find a fire or something like that. Wow, was that? Damn it! This is quite a tricky one. But I really like the idea of that, so that might be something I'm going to do. And if I can find one for like food, thirst, sleep deprivation, getting it all, like stuff like that, I think that would be really cool. If you guys know of any mods, oh, there we go. If you guys know of any mods that are on the console which are like that, then I'd very much like it. Because that's if I'm going to do any mod, that would be the first sort of mod that I'd be looking into doing. But if you guys have any suggestions for mods as well, I'm all ears. Because until mods came to consoles, I've never done a mod in my life before it came to consoles. So I'm all ears if you've got any suggestions. We were so close just then. Damn it! Do I need to go left or do I need to go right? With Master, like literally just an just like a millimeter makes all the difference. Come on. Bingo! There we go. At least now we're not going to get stabbed if we try and open this door. There better be something decent in here, because like a master lock. That holds back a lot, but... Yeah, like food, like thirst, hunger, stuff like that. Potion of stamina. I'll take it. I don't think I actually need that one. But that's stuff I'll definitely like to do. And like frost, what's it called? Hypothermia, stuff like that. Definitely something that would interest me. Other than that, a strong box which is empty. Come on now. But, yeah, stuff like that is something I'd definitely be interested in. And any suggestions that you guys have, I'll be open to listening to. Did Miko just get hurt? I'm pretty certain I just saw a health bar above his head then. Oh, I'm sorry, buddy. I didn't mean to hurt you. I have already looted that chest, haven't I? Yeah. I was too busy talking about mods. I got distracted. Speaking of getting distracted by stuff. Whew. Glad I noticed that in time. I'm not sure what that did. Did it turn off? I was going to say, did it turn off the axes? But they were turned off already. I'm sure it opened something. Maybe it opened one of these cages so we could get through or something. I mean, I really doubt there's a lever like that that it doesn't need to be pulled. Like, that would be a bit... That would be a bit shocking if that was the case. Bone meal, still arrow. Ancient arrow, bum, 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 bum. That is, I believe, what I need to activate. And that's opened that door over there. Okay, I see what it's doing. It's leading us on a bit of a wild goose chase, a bit of taking us around the scenic route before we eventually get to the beacon that we need. Thank you. I'll take 60 of your gold. Ooh, Battle of Red Mountain. That is value 50, so that's going to be a skill point. Ah, come on, I must have already read the book. God damn it. Okay, so I guess it is a skill point, unless you've already read that one, and then I'm guessing it's not. Oh, that seems so easy after the master log. Alterations, no. Gold, a lesser soul gem. Oh, some leather armor. If me and Janessa didn't already have some good leather armor, I probably would have took that. Oh, vigorous healing. Good, good, good. Oh, amethyst ring. Yeah, I'll sell that on. I'm definitely trying to build up as much gold as I can before I get to solitude, because I not only want to sell stuff off, but I do want to buy a few things as well. And also, I want to increase my smithing as well, and using like rings and stuff. Gee, I guess I wouldn't draw the bow again. That's becoming quite infuriating. I finished you off with a dagger. How do you feel? But yeah, I also using like rings and stuff like that and amethyst. You can also use them for smithing, but I'm probably gonna sell them off. Sell them off first. Shoot where they're gonna be. Not where they are. Damn it, he was moving too slow. I overshot. Seems like that was the last one. Desecrated corpse. Yep, yep, yep. Empty, empty, empty. Oh, that has a whole Indiana Jones thing going on. I don't need it, but let's take it anyway. There we go. Let's just put it back. Whoop! See, Gaston would make a great archaeologist. He knows how to avoid all these traps. Was it an archaeologist? That was what Indiana Jones was, wasn't it? An archaeologist? I'm pretty certain it was. Man, these Legion have so much money on them. So much coin. Thank you very much. I don't think I even need to bother looting urns anymore. I'll just loot the corpses of the Legion soldiers. 100 gold. Oh, man. No wonder this guy jumped across. Damn it, Miko. What are you doing? Oh, Miko, come on now. Yeah, no wonder he tried to escape. He had all that coin. He didn't want to lose it. Well, where's Janessa gone, actually? I need to give her...
And what might you... If that is what you wish...
Damn, I keep doing that! I keep accidentally picking up the stuff when I'm giving her accidentally. I don't want to quit that item. I want to give it to her. There we go. Yeah, I need to give her some more of those arrows I keep picking up. Good, good.
Lead on, then.
Because it's my understanding, I think they do actually... They do actually use the arrows. So if I give her steel arrows, it doesn't mean then she just has infinite steel arrows. Like, she will actually burn her way through them. Which is a good thing, because all you need to do is get, like, one ebony arrow. Well, I don't know if you have to get an ebony arrow. But all you need to do is get, like, one thing like that, and then, like, that's it. Like, she'll just use it for eternity, and that would be a bit OP. There we go, finally! Man, that took us on a real, like, scenic route, a wild goose chase. But finally, we've got to the last pedestal. And the door is open. I don't really fancy running all the way back around again, so I'm going to very gingerly take a shortcut. I'm sure Janessa and Miko can catch up. Right, before we go through here, I'm pretty certain, yeah, Killcreve Catacombs. This is probably going to be the end. This is probably going to be where the big head huncho is, so let's make sure we are prepared. Get a muffled spell on. Let's do a little quick save, make sure we are prepared. Janessa and Miko, I'm sure we'll catch up when we go through this door. Let's do this. Right, let's keep low and let's keep quiet throughout all of this. I'm looking at you, Miko. Oh, he's whimpering. Don't be scared, Miko. We've come across big bads like this before. No need to worry. We've survived last time, we'll survive again. Unless it's a Hagrave and then we're doomed. Battle of Orphan Rock will forever stay in my memories. There's some more of the Legion. There's a dead Legion. I'm sure there's probably a corrupted shade around here somewhere. Oh man, look, this one had so much gold it's even falling out of his pockets. Oh, God, I keep seeing like the that black mist out the corner of my eye, and I keep thinking it's one of the shades. Plentiful healing. Plentiful stamina. Oh man, I'm actually getting quite a few of these stamina ones. I might have to sell on or drop some of the lesser ones. Whoops. I mean, see, there's reasons like that where I wish they, you had like, the active looting that you could do in Fallout. Like, that would be quite good. It would save like, mistakes like that happening. Oh yeah, rightio, man. You got enough candles around here? Alright, Meridia, I've guided your light all the way through here now. I'm still yet to come across that Mal, or whatever his full name was. I'm still yet to come across him. Yeah, you can quite literally see the trouble in the air, this black mist. I've led your beacon all the way down here. I hope it's going to be worthwhile. And that, right there, I'm guessing is Mal. So I'm going to equip my one dwarven arrow. And I'm going to do this. I'm also going to make sure... I always forget to do this, so this time I'm actually going to remember. Is take my potion of true shot. That one does 30. I have a couple of others as well. They do 20. All right, so let's take the potion of true shot to make my bows do 30% more. Is there anything else I can do here? Restore 50 points. You appear invisible. This could come in handy. I think the second I shoot a bow, though, you become visible again. So I'll keep an eye on this just in case I get really hurt. But I think if I take it now, then it'll disappear as soon as I fire my bow. So this health regeneration's faster. Right. I think I'm ready. Let's do this. Right, that did a bit of damage. I want my switch to go back to my dwarven arrows. Otherwise, I'll be using. Oh no, you don't! Get out of my way, Shades. I want your master. Ha ha ha! Oh, I thought I switched to my dwarven axe. Miko, if you can get through the door, do. I want you to try and get some of the ones at the back. Yikes! Right, guys, you guys attack at the front. I'll attack from the back. Oh, Janessa's down. She's down, but she's not out. Yikes! Oh! Miko, you just hold them off at the door. Good boy. As long as they... Oh, I was going to say, as long as they can't get through, we should be all right. That is destroyed my stamina. I mean, I could level up, but I think that only does your health. It pretty does your stamina as well, but... Restore 50 stamina. Restore 75. We don't need that. Let's get one of the healing ones, because we are a little bit hurt. There's only one shade left. Alright, let's do this one-on-one. Let's get another health, because it looks like it's going to hurt me again. I know as well that I can, I could just, level up to do it, but that's cheating. I only do that if I'm in a real pinch. Yeah! Come on! Shade!
Oh. It is done. The Defiler is defeated. Take Dawnbreaker from its pedestal.
Alright, Meridia, I will do. I'm assuming that's that's my reward, unless I'm supposed to give it back to you. I was going to use Unrelenting Fall to shout them all back, but both Miko and Janessa were so badly hurt, if I had it, would have killed them both. Because if enemies attack them, they only sort of like get hurt, and that's it. But if you hurt them when they're nearly like they're on the edge, then you will kill them, and you can lose your companion, your follower forever. I mean, sometimes they can annoy me, but sometimes they save my butt. Like, when Miko was blocking that doorway... Like, that was a godsend, because they couldn't get through for a while. Oh, and there's Malkoran. My dwarven arrow, thank you, I have that back. 12 gold. Oh, healing hands. I think I already have the spell for healing hands, actually, so. Magic was 70% faster. An orcish dagger. Ooh, a staff of fireballs. I think I already have one that's like this, but it does, like, a consistent fire instead of just fireballs. So I'll definitely take that. I'll probably just sell it on, to be honest. Right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through and loot all these corpses, because if I go get Dawnbreaker now, it's probably going to end the quest. So I'm very, very quickly going to try and just run through and grab all of this stuff, because the second I grab Dawnbreaker, I believe it's just going to end this quest, and that'll be that done, and I won't get a chance to loot all these corpses. So let's get this done as quickly as I can, because I'm getting so much gold from these guys. Holy hell. And I'm loving every second of it. Well, I've got to say, like, I didn't plan on originally doing this quest. Like, we only come across that beacon just by... But yeah, that little beacon, that little gem, by like pure happenstance. We were just in a cave full of bears, and we just happened to come across it. So it was one of those quest that's sort of thrust upon you, and you sort of really didn't plan on doing it, but I'm really glad we have, because this has been bountiful. All this gold, a staff of fireballs that we can sell on as well. Like, this has definitely been worthwhile. So much gold! I was saying that I wanted more money for when I get to when I get to Solitude. It looks like the gods, and when I say that, I mean that quite literally, the god Meridia has heard me. What else do we have around here? Do we have any chests as well? Because I'm sure the chests probably have nowhere near as much gold as these Imperial soldiers do. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you! Alright, I think that is everyone looted now it is. Yep, that is everyone looted, so let's go get our prize for dispatching of all these people. And all the way, by the way, when you're doing this, I purposely took down Malkaren first, because he's the most powerful, and I believe he can also summon these from the grave. So by taking him down first, I think was definitely the best idea, because the shades you can sort of try and take down one by one, but if he's hitting you in the back as well while the shades are attacking you, it's just too much to take on at once. But oh, okay, you don't stand in the way of the light either, because apparently you're doing Meridia's bidding, but she will still punish you for it. Whoa, 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 she brought us all the way back up here again!
Malkaren is vanquished. Skyrim's dead shall remain at rest. This is as it should be. This is because of you. A new day is dawning, and you shall be its herald. Take the mighty Dawnbreaker, and with it purge corruption from the dark corners of the world. Wield it in my name, that my influence may grow.
Man, you let me keep Dawnbreaker? Man, this has definitely been worth it. All this gold we got to take down that evil Necromancer. Necromancers have been seeming to be our bread and butter recently. And you're giving me Dawnbreaker. Oh, fine, fair enough. I'll wield this mighty blade. Yeah, I will keep the sword, but yeah, find someone else to spread your religion. Like, I've already done enough for you. I'm not also going to be going door to door like a salesman trying to spread Meridia's light.
It matters not. The plant cares nothing for the rays that bring it the warmth of the sun. As you carry Dawnbreaker, so will my light touch the world.
Uh-oh. Where did she go?! Looks like I'm taking Dawnbreaker to the grave! Dogs! Meridia, you gotta stop just dropping me like that! At least last time you came down with me. Is everyone alright? Janessa? Miko? Oh, there's a fox, but what's she done with my companions? Oh, don't tell me they're still inside the cave, or... Oh, no, there they are. Oh, God. I thought they were still inside the cave, or that she dropped them, like, somewhere else. Like, we are all being thrown across Skyrim. Don't worry, boy. It's okay. I'm fine. I'm all right. Janessa, it seems like this has been worthwhile, because... Oh, I've got level up as well. I forgot about that. Because we've been given Dawnbreaker, which does 24, and RX does 22, so that's an upgrade. Burns for 10 points, and when killing undead, a chance to cause a fiery explosion that turns and destroys nearby undead. Holy hell! This thing is amazing. It weighs less than my orcish war axe. It does more damage and burns for 10 points. And when killing the undead, has a chance to cause a fiery explosion. Hell yes! This has just become my new go-to weapon. Let's unfavorite the orcish war axe, and now we have Dawnbreaker. This has been a worthwhile quest. I didn't want to do it at first, but this has been worthwhile. Rightio, rightio. I have always put this in health. I keep putting it in health, so I think I'm actually going to put it in stamina for once. Especially when I get attacked by the ancient Nords or by any necromancer that hits me with frost, my stamina decreases at an alarming rate. Okie pokey, okie pokey. What are we at? What do we have? Oh, two more increases before we can add another one to a one-handed. I think it was something in like archery or speech or possibly light armor, I believe I wanted to do. Oh, it's a shame I can't do that one. I'd like to slow down time. Oh no, it was it was the dagger, wasn't it? It was under sneak, I think I wanted to do. Oh, I was hoping I could upgrade my armor as well. Yes, and it's active as well! Finally! Assassin's Blade. Sneak attacks with daggers now do a total of 15 times normal damage. Oh, we're right on the money for it as well. Oh, this has just made it even better. Where I normally sneak through caves and I hit them with the bow first, I can now sneak up behind them and assassinate them with a blade. A dagger that does, what is it? It does a total of 15 times the normal damage. That is insane. I mean, if we look at the dagger I have now, it's just a fine orcish dagger. Isn't amazing, just does 12. 12 times 15, I'm useless at quick math. So I'm actually going to sit there and just type this in my little calculator right now. Vaped for time? That's not the word. I should have just stalled time and made it out like I actually did it the math in my head. But that, this orcish war axe that does 12 damage will do 100. Damn it, I think it was 150. I've literally just forgot what it was. My short-term memory is awful, but I literally just did that on the calculator. It does like 150 damage when you times that by 15, something like that. 150, 180, one or two. So that is insane. Normally it'd be like, what, 10? 10 and 30, so that's 40 with extra 10 of burnings. That would have done 50 damage with a bow, times that by 6 or something, I don't know. But yeah, that is, it's amazing. It's amazing is what I'm getting at, like, before I fumbled my words and showed how useless my math and short-term memory is. But, alright, fair enough. I didn't originally plan on coming here. I didn't originally plan on helping a god bring light back into a temple and vanquish an enemy, but it's turned out this has been a worthwhile quest. It really has. But with that being said and done, we're all here, we're all safe, and I now have a new favourite weapon, being in Dawnbreaker. But that being said and done, I think it's time that we leave Mount Kilcreath and we make our way up to Solitude. It's something I've been wanting to get to for a while, and I have so much loot that I need to sell off right now, so let's make our way back down the hill and make our way to Solitude.